I'm making a video series about the book Goodbye Things from Fumio Sasaki. In the previous two videos, I shared with you my favorite tips from the book and also how to implement minimalism in all aspects of life. And in this video, I'm sharing with you what the tips are that I do not agree on and also some things that I see differently or that are not really suitable for my situation. I'm not sharing this to be negative about the book. I just want to talk about all assets of the book and not only the things that I like. This is the third and final video of this series, so let's head right in. There's no need to stock up. When your storage space is limited, I can imagine it's better to not stock up. And even when you do have enough storage space, I think it's important to be realistic. Personally, I do stock up on some foods and household supplies, and I do that because I try to reduce my amount of waste. And buying in bulk often makes a big difference, and it's also often a lot cheaper, so that kills two birds with one stone. So having some extra storage space is quite a luxury in that sense. So by not having a lot of stuff and junk in my basement and attic, I'm able to mindfully choose which items I want to stock up on. The city is our personal floor plan. I do not live in a city and I do not have a floor plan. No, but seriously, I do not agree with this one. And Fumio Sasaki explains this one. The example he gives in the book is when he wants to have dinner with friends or family and they would want to have hot pot. He would say, we can't have hot pot at my place, it's too small, but I know a really good restaurant in town which has very delicious hot pots and we can have hot pot over there and then we can have drinks at my place afterwards. I would not want to rely only on restaurants and public places to meet for dinner with my family or with friends. I love to host dinners at my home and I also love it when I'm invited for dinner at someone else's place. And I think eating in the comfort of your own home is just the nicest thing and is not as loaded as eating in a restaurant. There's also something about just being with the people you're meeting, and in the restaurants there are always other people who are serving you or also eating there. And the book, of course, is written a while ago, but especially in these days, it's nice to be able to be in your own home with family, and not to mention the costs of going out for dinner or lunch or whatever. That would just add up too much for me, and I would also not want my guests to have extra costs because I have a small home. I think having the opportunity to invite a small group of people to your home is just very lovely. Think of buying as renting. Fumio explains in his book that he knows someone that buys and wears new clothing every season. He buys clothing and keeps the price tags and takes very good care of his clothing, so they remain in perfect shape and the resale value is pretty high. And he kind of sees it as renting the clothes from the store. And after the season, he sells it secondhand. And for the next season, he rents new clothing from the store. So he kind of views buying the clothes as renting them and then reselling to get his money back. I do not agree that this is a minimalist approach. I think it would be better to go for something of high quality that you believe is beautiful and you would want to wear for years to come and can wear over and over again. I think it is a waste of your money, of the environment, and of your time to buy new things every season just to wear something new. Another tip Fumio gives in his book is to consider wearing a uniform and keeping your wardrobe simple, so I don't think this tip is even in line with his own practice. It's easier to revisit your memories once you go digital. Fumio recommends taking pictures of things you are decluttering and also scanning photos and letters you are decluttering. I do personally think it is a good tip to take pictures of things, but I do not think that they are easier to revisit once they are digital, because I always find it harder to find something on my laptop than in real life, for example, a picture I'm looking for. I think that once something becomes digital, it kind of loses its energy and its magic. I do think that you remember certain things better once you declutter them, because you revisit the memory and you, for instance, reread a letter. And I also think that your brain kind of knows that there's a necessity to remember the item and the contents of the letter. I do think that your brain stores the information better because there's actually a need for you to remember it. Tackle the nest before the pest. When you have to get rid of a pest, you're not going to kill every insect one by one and then get rid of the nest. you would first get rid of the nest and then kill the remaining insects, because that would be a way more efficient approach. And Fumio Sasaki says it is the same when we are decluttering our things. We should first get rid of the nest, he says, which are our closets, and then get rid of the pest, which are our things and our stuff. He says this method works because once you get rid of the nest, your closet, the stuff from your closet will be scattered all around your home, and most people are not able to bear this much disorder in their home. So during the next days, they will declutter and organize all those things. I have decluttered several closets, but I have never used this method because I cannot bear that much disorder in my life. Once a closet was almost empty, I did try to empty the closet by decluttering and rearranging stuff, but I always emptied the closet first and then got rid of the closet, because I would just get stressed if I would get rid of a closet and then end up with things that do not have a proper home. The danger of things in a natural disaster. Fumio Sasaki stresses the importance of having less in case there would be a natural disaster. Japan is quite prone to earthquakes, so I can imagine that it would be safer if there were not books in bookcases that could fly around during an earthquake and possibly hit your head. I'm personally very blessed to live in a country where natural disasters hardly ever happen, so this was never really a motivation for me to get rid of certain things. But it does give me peace of mind that in case there would be an emergency, I do know where my valuable items are and I would be able to grab them within a minute and leave the house. Of course, I hope this would never happen and there would never be a need for me to know that, and I do think that this tip is good for people who live in a country that is prone to natural disasters, and I think it's always useful to go over the items you would need in a disaster and know your escape rooms to leave the house. Oh, and a little off topic, if you don't have a fire extinguisher yet, go get one. Seriously, make sure to get one that works on oil and on electricity. You will thank yourself if you ever need it. Well, that concludes this series. Hello, Rambo. This little monkey wants to go on a walk, so I guess we are going to do that. Well, that concludes this series. If you haven't seen the first two videos, please go check them out. I'll leave them in the cards for you. And they're also in my minimalism playlist, which I will leave at the end screen for you. I hope you subscribe to my channel and give this video a like. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.